Hello everybody, it's Suffolk Blue, all the way from Merry Old England. How the devil are you? I hope you are well. Welcome back to Minecraft here on the Viva Variety Server, the Infinity of Old Mod Pack on the Expert Crafting. Now, I'm standing in front of the face of the goddess. Now, this goddess may very well end up being a sort of non-gender-specific god, a non-gender-specific deity at this rate, but we are going to attempt today to try... Whoops, wrong buttons. I've been playing too much Skyrim. Keep putting the wrong buttons. I'm going to try... Whoa, flying about. Oof, that was close. We're going to try today to make some effort to turn this beautiful creature face into something that looks a little... with a little bit of hair is what we're going to be looking for. And I'm thinking about doing two types of stone to do this. Let me just swap some of these over. So I've got some limestone and some crag rock. Now, crag rock I can't do anything with, so I can't cut it, chop it, or do anything with it on chisel. It is a biome's a plenty of rock, it's just what it is. Chisel, of course, can be used on limestone because limestone is a chisel block. So let's start off. All I'm going to do to start with is to get a feeling of what this colour looks like. Now, luckily, because we've set this back, I can start this sort of just by... doing sort of that sort of jobby. Let's have a little look. Something like that. It's basically going to come out of the back of the face, if you like. The face. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run some of this along here. Because it's supposed to flow out of the top of her head and round. So let's do that. Let's take this round. I've got my spade on me actually, so let's make a way for this to go round this mountain. If the worst comes to the worst and this doesn't work, we can put it back. We've not lost anything or caused any great problem. Now at the moment that's going to be one long flat line, which is not necessarily what I want to look for. But it's okay, because what we can also start to do is that block. Okay. It's one flat line along that edge. Let's take this up and down again. Let's put some shape. Oops, put some shape into it. This this crag rock is actually quite easy to come by. It's the whole biomes of it that exists, so you can really easily get it out of the ground. So all we're going to do really is I'm going to play around with some of the shape on this. Okay. And then rather than go straight underneath, I'm going to come across and do something very similar. Now, to start with, you're going to look at this and go, what on earth are you doing? I've got a plan in my head. Now, I haven't done this in creative first, though, which is probably why this is going to look a little bit haphazard to start with. And you know what it's like. I'm going to spend about 3 hours fiddling around with it anyway before I'm happy with it. So, let's get rid of that edge. But the main thing is to begin to bring in these colours. Go up here. Take a little step back and see what that colour green is going to look like. That's fine. So I am literally going to play around with some of this, feeling it around, doing it in bands, and I'm going to do it in bands probably a break, I would have thought, of two or so blocks each time. So something like this again, we broke them. I want to try and keep the as natural rock face or, you know, mountainside face as possible, hillside face as possible. But I do need to feed in from the head. Now that goes up at that point, so actually we should probably follow that curve that I've already started. There is a slight curve is what I'm going to be doing. You're going to see this go up and down. This one's gone up and down, not massive amounts, and I may extend and raise that. But the idea basically is to make it look as if the ancients, or the people, whoever built this particular monument to this particular god, has built it within the rock face. Okay. Yeah, something like that. So then we can go up here. And down again. And I don't mind... Ooh, now do I want them to touch? Probably not at this stage. May change that around later. Again, texture is going to be important, so it can't all be flat and ingressed. I'm going to need to pull it forward. All the way around. So, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut up talking, and we're going to do some time-lapse and throw a time-lapse in here to see what this is going to look like. And you can watch me build this over time and get a feeling for what I'm doing. And if I do anything interesting, or if I decide to do something interesting, then I will bring you back and explain what it is I'm doing. So I shall continue. I should be right back. Well, you can just watch. And then I should be right back. Thank you. Well, there she is, everybody. I'm quite pleased with that. Now, I know it's all very conceptual, and if you look at it, I suppose if you looked at it, it's from certain angles, it might look a bit different, but actually, I think it does give her a feminine type of personality. It feels that sort of look. It's like a cascade. The whole point is, it's like, if you can imagine a woman with long, scraggly hair that's being sort of wind blasted from behind, as if there's like going out, you know, the hair is sort of going out crazy from either side, because it's like the mouth of the mountain. This is the way that the sort of role play behind this to me is that this wasn't built by the people inside the mountain. It wasn't this goddess wasn't built by the people who ultimately built all of the stuff inside our base once it's built. This was built by people who lived outside the base, who saw this waterfall that will come cascading out of there as a, you know, as a thing, and maybe even by the people who built these farms and villages out here. Maybe they built this. This is a scary place for people to come, because it was seen as a dangerous place in my mind. This is like a swampland, you know, vines and trees and flowing water and scary stuff, scary noises, maybe even from the wind that whistles through that hole. So I think that gives her a bit of a look. Certainly it's man-made. It certainly looks like it's man-made. What I did do, as you can see, I used a different type of stone as well. I used a limestone under chisel, like a darker version. Ultimately, you've got to go with this. You've got to use your colour palettes. So we wanted something which was bluey-green, which would complement that bluey-green. I was going to use cement, because cement is that sort of dark colour. Actually, let's get some... Well, it'll look like at night, but that glowstone is going to glow up. Yeah, looks reasonably good. You can see the glowstone from the eyes of the goddess lights up. I think that's a pretty... If you were to come through this... Imagine, you've got to imagine, like, you're coming through the swamplands, you've got all these willows in your way, and you don't really know where you're going, and then suddenly you come upon that. I think that is pretty spectacular. I think that's exactly the sort of look I wanted to go for. I might still use a bit of cement in there as well, actually, to darken it down. Shall we have a look? Because again, it's all about contrast of colour, highs and lows, and texture. Whoops, I'm running out of power on my jetpack as well. But it's all about contrast. So where we've got, you know, the green, the blues of the crag rock, obviously we've got the darkness of this limestone. Have I got any... I don't think I've made... I've got andesite. There's a thought. We have got some gravel. Let's quickly run it through the system and see what colour that comes out like. We only need a couple of bits, because you only need a couple of bits to get a feeling as to whether or not that colour's going to look... Whether that colour's going to... Oh, that iron's done. That's good. Whether that colour will look right, how it's going to fit in. But you can see the sort of similar colours. It's similar, actually. Slightly paler than that other than the darkened limestone. Can I chisel concrete? I don't know whether I can. I can. Now, that might be too dark, this weathered stuff. This concrete partly weathered. Well, it's certainly darker. Look, it's definitely darker than this one, which is light dark. You know what I mean? You can see the sort of the shade as it colours through. Let's pop this up here and have a look and see. I don't want to overdo it, because I am quite happy with lots of the bits that are in here. But let's just say, for example, we want a piece, I don't know, there. Have a little stand back, have a look. I'm definitely going to put some of that in there then, because that does work quite well, that sort of grading through. So I'll just carry on and do a bit more of that. I should be right back. Okay, welcome back, everyone. So I have dotted in there and about a little of the darker material. Sometimes less is more, so you don't want to overdo it. The predominant colour there is still got to be that crag rock green, because I want that to pull forward, and also because that's a completely unnatural colour for this landscape, so it certainly looks man-made. But that's sort of all I want to do for her hair, actually. It works. It does what I wanted it to do. Let me know what you think of the comments, because I think this is one of those things that's going to divide people. Some people are going to look at this and go, it's hideous. Some people are going to look at it and go, yeah, it's okay. And some people are going to look at it and go, it's great. So have a look at it. Tell me what you think. But the overall effect is, what I want you to imagine is you're coming through the sort of swamplands, you're coming through all the trees, and you can see something ahead, and you come through, and boom, that's what you've got. And similarly, if you were coming through these mountains, you know, from well away, you would look at them and go, wow, there's something. I mean, there's going to be more trees up here as well, because I'm going to plant these back. I've actually stripped them. But as you're coming through here, you know, you're going to get to see that on the skyline as it comes through. So it kind of does what I wanted. It does do what I wanted it to do, actually. But let me know what you think. It's one of those things, and I would love to hear from you. I don't like that. Thanks. So I got rid of. Too light, too bright. Don't want any light colours in there, so that's gone. Good. Okay, so what's the other stuff that we've got to do? Well, I want to just quickly talk to you. Let's get rid of all this stuff out of my main inventory, because we're sort of done with that. Let's bring in some dirt, because, and I'm not going to do this on camera, don't panic, but the next stage for in here, this is about as big as I think we're going to go. We can always go bigger, because I can push that way as far back as I like, really, because there's plenty of mountains still to go. And I've made a bit of a start over here, but the next job is to line all these walls, and to begin to drop them down so they begin to look natural. So what we're going to do, essentially, if you can imagine, is we're going to start, you know, almost, I don't know, something like that maybe, and that will be another layer down. So we're going to layer all of these, and I've got to sit here and do this by manual. Oops, too fast. Oops. So essentially I'm going to sit here and use up a ton of dirt. In fact, I'll probably see whether Digi and others have got some spare dirt, because I know they've got ender quarries running and they probably aren't going to need that much topsoil. But essentially I'm going to run this dirt all the way down these mountain sides. Whoops. All the way down to the base floor. All the way down. And then I'm going to do probably another one as well, all the way down to the base floor. And try and making it look as sculptured and natural as possible, whilst also making it look man-made, which sounds really weird. But it's like, the ancestors that had all of this land did carve it. They didn't just find it naturally like this. So it's got to look like that, but they use the land as much as possible. That's my backstory that I've got for this. So, you know, again, this is going to come forward probably only by about a couple each inside. I want to keep as much of this as sheer-faced as possible, although we will do some of those little overhangs slightly lower down. So this is probably going to come out probably to about... Oops. Not you. One, two... Probably... This is actually going to be workable space. The rest of this is going to be filled in on each corner. So as we go around, every part of it will be covered by dirt to make it look as natural as possible. We'll let the grass grow all the way down the edges and do everything that it needs to do. I am going to leave the first part of this goddess temple, the gateway, the entranceway, if you like, clear of dirt at the moment, because I'm not quite sure how I'm going to build my temple in there. There is going to be a building at the other end of this, which will control the water flow of the water that gushes out of the mouth into our rivers and then flows either way out to sea. So lots of work to do there. But again, let me know what you think about that goddess's face. I will do all the dirt work off camera. I'm not going to do it all in one sitting. It won't be ready next time, I can assure you. It's going to take a long time for me to go around this and do all the little bits and bobs. We can, as I say, push this way, and I'm going to have to push this way, because at some point, obviously, we've got the cirque up the top here, which we're going to make. This is also going to be where the main temple is going to be, because all of the life, all of the water, all of the good stuff that flows through my valley comes from here. So this is going to be our main water temple, the temple to the water goddess, if you like. That water will then flow through my base somehow, and then flow out of the mouth of the face of the goddess at the bottom here. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. I know it's obviously you've just watched me build a lot of blocks, but do let me know what you think. Let me know how we're getting on. Let me know if there's anything you want me to see, do, or otherwise. Leave a little like if you wouldn't mind. That would be great. If you're not a subscriber yet and want to come along for the journey, do hit that subscribe button. It'd be fantastic to have you along for the journey. Do check out all the other players who are on the Viva Variety server, have a look at our Twitter account, have a look at our Votable as well, which has got loads of content from all the other guys, not just on the Variety server, but also on the Viva Vanilla server, and the other more than just Minecraft stuff that we do. Haven't heard back from anyone yet regarding any other series as they would like to see me play. I really am thinking I'd quite like to do maybe a Fallout 4 episode, but let me know what you think. But until next time, from me, Sonic Blue, here in the Minecraft lands, you take care of yourselves. I'll see you soon.